nice chunk, actually. It's kind of like these rolling ridges of these white, big white and red pine. There's some oaks back here too. So we're as far back almost as you could go on the public. We kicked one off the roost about halfway. This morning we got in the parking lot about 4 o'clock. And Cory let him know we were here by sending off his alarm of his vehicle. So they know we're here to come and get him. But we heard here gobbling out on this field over here. And then we heard one fly down. I think there's actually two goblins. But we're gonna sit tight. We might have to pick up and run gun. I don't know. Hopefully it's a quick hunt. Hopefully Corey's calling works today. So we're at a new location. The wind has picked up a bit. And there's a little grassy field that's next to this big stuff. First we spotted a hen. And then there's a dirt field next to that. We actually saw four others, and we saw one of them was at least a tom. So our goal is to kind of just loop around, set up in this grass over here. We think they went in the field on the opposite side, so we're going to try setting up. Perhaps we're going to call them. We have the decoys, so we might set those up, but we'll make our decision when we're there. Alright, so that was successful. We actually made it through this really thick stuff. I feel like we were really quiet. We got the grass all down here. And then the dirt. It's just on the edge of that. And then there's this strip of woods, and we think that's where they went. There's a field on the other side. So they could be in that field. But that's all private. shot. So we reviewed the footage, and I missed. Looked like it went almost underneath him, and it clipped just underneath his wing. So I didn't get him. I shaved him a little bit. Yeah, so what they did was... We were contemplating what we were going to do, because where we set up just over across the way, I didn't really like that spot, but nothing was coming.
Where they were at.
So yeah.
We just kind of jumped in there.
Yeah, we didn't know where they were, so.
Until that one, the freaking crow saved us. Because that crow caught, and we heard him gobble, and then we knew they were down there.
Yeah. So then we heard, so what we did was, they instead of going that way, which we thought they did initially, they must have looped in the field behind us here. Unless it was two different times, but...
I think that was the same one.
And then we heard them gobbling over here, and we were actually thinking about what the heck are we gonna do. And then all of a sudden he gobbled again, and we're like, okay, he's coming. So we scrambled. We moved the decoys out. Move the blind.
I figured they were gonna come right up that grass where we were sitting right up behind us.
I thought that's what they were gonna do too.
And they did. I mean, they come right up here, and I didn't get them on video. They went right down behind you.
Yeah. So we moved over here underneath this tree, and then they were coming along the fence line over here, and we thought we were busted. And Cory was calling them. You might be able to hear it on the audio, but. They came directly behind us.
Spitting and drumming the whole way.
And then they looped back, went through the fence again, drew the bull right where I could, and it just felt like I was holding forever. And then they got to the decoy and they wouldn't stop moving, and I was thinking I gotta fire sooner or later here because I can't hold it.
Took a shot at the dominant. He was not happy with that Jake decoy.
I don't know.
Let's go look down and make sure he break his wing and his flopper open.
Yeah, I doubt it, but... that was exciting, though.
For the rest of the afternoon, Cory and I bounced around from property to property in hopes of getting on another bird, but came up empty each time. We saw lots of turkeys and several other nice toms, but they were always on the private. And as we were putting boots to the ground, all I could think about was how I had let us down. That our hunt should have been over. After reviewing the footage over and over and processing the failure, I came to grips with reality that not everything is perfect. Not every hunt leads to a kill. In bull hunting, nothing is 100%. Mistakes will be made, but it's important to learn from those mistakes and move forward. Instead of dwell on this experience, I plan to learn from it. So when the next time Big Tom comes strolling in, I'll get it done.